Evening folks, this is Best in Slot and we are back with part 2 of our look at the best workshop mods that the Planet Zoo workshop has to offer. I've picked out 5 of my favourites that were uploaded in the past 7 days. We're going week by week on this. As per usual, I've tried to keep things relatively mixed up. I'm not going for full exhibits because I think that's not typically that useful, but these are all things that you could bring into your zoo in order to supplement your zoo, especially with the beta ending in a few days. If you're trying to hurriedly finish your zoo at the end, which I definitely am, then maybe bringing in some outside help will, well, help. So the first thing we're going to look at is the Monkey Temple. This is a large shelter made by Floss on the workshop. Let's take a look at it. First of all, it is awesome. Let's just get that out of the way. It is, of course, an Indian-styled shelter. The only thing you need to make this work is indeed the Indian theme. And this whole thing is a shelter for your lemurs, your mandrills and stuff to play in and enjoy. You can see here we've got a staircase at the bottom and then there's a little bit of wood up there so that the monkeys will actually use it as appropriate. And you can see the same over here on the right hand side. Just little details here, little bits of wooden ramp integrated into the Indian temple to make it climbable for your primates. So let's head inside, have a little look around. I actually haven't explored inside. We've got a little sleeping area down here, a little bit of detail there, some pots and pans, some lovely windows, another sleeping area around here, and we've got a box, we've got a rug, and we can begin to head upstairs. I believe you can climb to the very top of the building. We can get up one more floor, look out into the world. You could even repurpose this if you wanted to. Get rid of the wood, get rid of the bedding, and you could just use this as an Indian temple in your zoos, and it would be absolutely fine. So we're on to the second floor. There's yet more bedding, yet more toys. What I really like about this is, in theory, what this will do is make your lemurs, your mandrills, etc., climb the entire thing. They should explore all of the different floors because there's bedding on every floor. There's enrichment items on every floor. I am stuck in the wall. Right, there we go, there we go. Right, so let's head up one more floor. I could hold shift and slow things down a little bit. We're on to the roof. Very cool. There's my panagar over there. Yeah, I mean, it gives us a great view, if nothing else, but I think this would be a really cool thing to see the lemurs jumping all around. You see we've got another bedding area here, nice and open space, so you should see them when they're over here. And yeah, just little things like this, you know, we've got this gap here, and then there's a climbing frame over it. There's lots of little spaces, more bedding areas for your monkeys to climb and enjoy. Again, here you'd see them running along the outskirts of the building. I think that would look really, really cool. And again, here, like, this is all wood. So what I really do like about this is obviously it's impeccably well made, but it's the integration of the wood into the Indian temple that means your lemurs and mandrills at the moment will properly use it. You'll see them darting all over the entire thing, and yet from the outside, the wood really doesn't stand out. It doesn't ruin the aesthetic of the Indian temple. It's very cool. Well done, Floss. Big thumbs up. Let's go check out item number 2. And we're going in a completely different direction with item number 2. This is the Spheric Geodesic Dome by Vigoga, or Vigoga, however you pronounce that. This is built simply using the hexagon items from the New World set. Very, very simple in theory, but to actually put this together in practice so it looks like this is, in my opinion, fairly incredible. Now, this is not the best example. I'm going to bring up an image very quickly from the workshop, and you'll see what this looks like when put into game and integrated properly, made into like a little rainforest dome kind of thing. It looks so cool. It's got this very new world, modern age, futuristic even vibe to it, which I think looks fantastic. You can, of course, head inside and get this incredible patterning at the top. The light that comes down is going to be really interestingly patterned as well. The whole thing only sets you back about $10,000, something like that. You could definitely integrate a couple of these into your park. I've sunk one into the earth, which I think is how you're usually going to use it, but you could maybe find a reason to use it like this. I don't know what that would be. One day, if we do get flying birds integrated into Planet Zoo, this could be one of the coolest aviary-style buildings ever. This, yeah, it could be absolutely amazing. Oh my god, I can run up it. It's like one of those like extreme sport ball things. I should be on a motorbike right now. How awesome is this? Look at the patterning, the colors, the light coming through. All these different hexagons. Now, the hexagon tool is great. I've actually used it on the surface of my building over there. But to string it together like this so perfectly is pretty impressive. You can see, if you look down, I think this bit in particular, there's a little bit of crossover, which I assume was necessary to make the building stick together. But generally speaking, it is, and you can see it a bit there as well, it is nigh on perfect. It really is. It's super impressive. And I think if you're building like a modern zoo, this is one of the workshop items I would understand, because this is a lot of work and a lot of time. You know, this would take a long time to build. So I could understand definitely downloading this workshop item and integrating this straight into your own parks. Very, very cool. Possibly my favorite from today. Number three on our list, as I go back and try to find something moderately more useful, is this employee building by Kong G. And it is literally just called employee building. And it is a really, really beautiful staff building, essentially, that should contain everything you need to get your zoo started right from the off. I love stuff like this because at the start of the zoo, I don't really want to spend ages doing a staff facility. I like just sticking it together like that. We've got these lovely flags hanging up outside. It's just a nice looking modern building with some hints of glass architecture from the outside. We're going to head inside. We're also going to check it out at night because it's very cool at night. We can walk in over here. You can see, oh, lovely. I mean, just little details like that. Doesn't that look really cool, actually? These vines are really nice. I'm going to have to find out what they are and use them in my own park. So we've got the keeper hut. We've got the sort of staff little rest area in here. We've got the workshop on the right-hand side, which, again, it's got the metal door there. It's a little bit more rugged looking. Little bit of tree there. Kong G, come on, sort it out. Over here, we have another exit and also the veterinary area. Let's take a little look from the outside. A little bicycle waiting there, you know, makes a lot of sense. And we can, I suspect I meant to put in the staircase myself, so I'll go do that. So as with a lot of Planet Zoo buildings that you're going to download for the workshop, you will have to add the pathing yourself. I believe they want to integrate the pathing into the workshop eventually. I think that is the plan, but I don't believe it's been done quite yet. I totally screwed up this staircase. If you're better than me, I promise you'll be able to handle this. But this one did fit in really, really nicely. So we can head upside the building. There's another workshop up here. There is a research center. Oops, oh god, I thought I nailed this one and I've kind of screwed that up as well. But there we go. And you can head further up again. You probably want to put some stuff here. And up here we've got a little utility area with a transformer and a water treatment plant. And again, you should probably put some pathing over there. That's totally my, I'm making this look much worse than it actually is. But it's a really, really cool looking building, and if you're not terrible with the path tool like I am, you'll be able to make it look great. We're just going to quickly shift this up. Oh, hello, calm down, love. We're going to shift this over to nighttime because I think it's worth just looking at how it glows at night. This is the big benefit of that glass walling. First of all, you can see the shops as well. Not the shops, but the veterinary workshop there. You know, just that lovely white glow really contrasts really well with the sort of the yellow glow that the rest of the building has been given. It looks beautiful at nighttime. It really, really does. And even that mess of a staircase that I've put in doesn't look so bad at night. It's just a beautiful little staff building. There's some really nice modern staff buildings out there. I kind of like this one with a little bit more of the traditional approach in some ways. And I think it's worth checking out if you need a staff building and you know how to use a path tool. So there it is as well, from a nice zoomed out angle. Beautiful thing, absolutely beautiful. Let's go check out number four on our list. We're getting there, folks, we're getting there. Number four on our list, as I do a dramatic reveal, is the Sundial Centerpiece by Plastic Swan. Definitely go check this one out as well. This is a perfect item for just general zoo decoration. You've got a big plaza, you need something in the middle of it. The game doesn't provide that much in terms of fountains, etc. You could definitely cover this in fountains and surround it with stuff like that. But if you wanted something just really original and huge, smack bang in the middle of your plaza, this would be absolutely perfect. And it's definitely the kind of thing I've seen in zoos before. Now, obviously, it's not a functioning sundial. That would be crazy. But it is a beautiful looking, elaborate piece of design that would really suit any, even classical or modern zoo design. It really could suit either really, really well. Shines beautifully, and the light's all got this sort of bronze colouring to it, which is really, really cool. Obviously not in the letters, they're just brown, unfortunately. But nothing we can really do about that. It's really, really well put together. That people have managed to create this kind of thing in Planet Zoo kind of blows my mind. Who came up, why a sundial? I don't know, but I'm glad that they did, because it looks great. It's got that, I don't know, it's just really cool. And it's absolutely perfect for a big centerpiece in your zoo. You'd walk forward, smack bang in the middle like this, surround it with pathing, surround it with trees and fountains and plants, and you've got an incredible way to open up the rest of your zoo with paths spiraling off from this central point. Go check out Plastic Swan's Sundial Centerpiece. It's cool, basically, is what I'm trying to get across here. And cool things are cool. Finally then, the most expensive item I've ever shown you at nearly 100k, about 92,000 for this building. This is the Reptile Center by Paul's Lay. This is a huge, beautiful, modern wood and glass, again with those hexagons complex, that is going to contain basically all the exhibit items you could possibly want. So let's do a little tour. You would of course have to path through this thing, which should be fairly simple if you're not terrible like me. We've got a lovely chief beef and a lovely gulpy here, and you put those there. We've got a bathroom in the middle. Let's walk forward. We've got a little conservation sign. Again, it's just, I love these things that feel very well put together and very logically thought out. These little lampposts on the brick, the little shaded area over the conservation sign. Got some cobras in each corner facing inwards like so. I'll do a little tour of the outside first, and then we will head in. Well, this is actually the main center, so I should have come in this way, I guess. Reptile center, there we go. Lovely, bright and colorful. Continue our tour of the outside. We've got a little plaza here with some umbrellas, some parasols. And again, another area that could well be a center. This is good. We've got multiple possible entrances at the end of the day. Reptile center again with the cobras standing there looking beautiful as they always do. More conservation signs always shrouded so you can see the screen, you know, even in the middle of the day. That's very clever. And there we are again. Each entrance just looks a teeny tiny bit different from the others, which I think is very cool and important. Let's head inside. And there we go. Bam. We've got a little signpost there sitting in this lovely covered garden area, and our first turret. I love the use of the plank wood. This is one of the construction items. That is a great looking terrarium right there. I don't want to make like a huge deal out of that, but I think that alone is really, really cool looking. We'll have to come back at night time and check how this looks when lit up. Got three in here. I think all the rooms are probably pretty much the same by the looks of it. Yeah, so you've got three rooms with three terrariums in each. Each one is like a little mini dome. If we zoom out a little bit, we take a look at this from the sky, you can get a feel for the general shape of it, how well put together it is. You can kind of feel why it's so expensive. There's a lot of detail in there. Of course, the nine terrariums are $45,000 all on their own. So the rest of the building comes to about $47,000. Right, let's go take a quick little gander at nighttime. As with everything else, this looks lovely. Let's have a look inside. Yeah, it's pretty much what you would want, you know? It's just really cool. I don't really know what else to add. It just looks really nice. Each room's identical. It feels very professional. It feels like you could definitely see this in a real zoo. Really, really cool way of displaying all your animals. And the hexagon, well, not the hexagon this time, but the triangle glasswork on the roof is really, really smooth. There's no overlay, no overlaps. It all just fits perfectly into these, what looks like plaster or limestone, something like that, into these sort of edging that it's got here. It just fits in perfectly. It's just really professional work. It really is. That's all I can say about it. Really cool work. Go check it out. The Reptile Center. This is actually the most popular item on the workshop this week, and you can definitely see why when you look at it. If you wanted an easy way to display your terrariums, admittedly quite expensive, but that's because there's nine of them. If you wanted a good way to display your terrarium animals, this is basically the perfect building for it. So, hope you've enjoyed these fairly incredible items. There were a couple others I wanted to show you, but unfortunately not everything on the workshop actually works. There's a pirate boat that looks really, really cool, but unfortunately the download does not function at this point in time. And that's about it. This will be the last time we do this video for a little while now. Obviously, I can't really do this when the beta ends, and the beta ends in a few days. When the Planet Zoo real game comes out, when the full game comes out, we'll be back with this series. We'll be doing it every single week, highlighting the best workshop items. If you wanted shelters, if you wanted centerpieces, if you wanted stores, if you want big ass geodesic domes, whatever you want, we're going to try to provide it. Thank you so much for joining me. As per usual, go check out these five workshop items. I will of course link them down below in the description so you can download them for yourselves. Thanks for joining me. Cheers much as always. Bye bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.